Morning, Winnie. Morning, pork sausage. Morning, mini Winnie. Just 5 more minutes, guys. Everyone, Big Pauly back for another video! Yes, it's Star Wars Blu-ray Monday. So we're gonna go out in a minute. We're gonna go and do some shopping in Tesco's, Sainsbury's and all the other places. I've got some little furry friends with me today. Get in there. There they are, they're coming shopping with me today. See what we can find out there. So, we're going to head off in a minute. I'm going to pop into Tesco's Dover first. I just want to see what kind of display, Star Wars display, they've got. Because they had quite a good one when Rogue One came out. So, we're going to have a look. I need to get some breakfast, though. I'm going to have to do McDonald's today, so I'll probably get something like a bagel and a cappuccino. So, let's get on the road, and I'll see you up at Tesco's in a minute.
A few moments later...
Yeah, hi, can I have a sausage, egg and cheese bagel, please?
Is that the meal?
What's it just come with a cappuccino?
A drink and a hash brown.
Yeah, I'll have as a meal, please, as well.
A drink?
Cappuccino.
Yeah, is that your order complete?
You don't have any kyber crystals, do you?
Sorry?
No, that's it, that's all my order.
Okay, that's £4.19 next window, then, please. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, so I just arrived at Tesco's in Dover. I've got my lovely morning cappuccino. This is going to go down very nice. The guys have got their bagel. And what have they got? They've got a hash brown and a cheese and whatever bagel there. So they'd be happy. So we're going to go into Tesco's in a minute. Going to have a look, see what they got in there. And then we'll piss off down to Westwood Cross. Also today, around about midday time, I'm meeting up with one of my subscribers, which lives down around the area. Surprisingly, I think he works in Dover as well. So we're going to have a chat, have a coffee in Costa, do a bit of catching up. I've also got a steelbook for him, which is the Star Wars Best Buy, the same one that I got, so I'll give that to him. I don't think he wants to be on camera just yet anyway, so we'll have a coffee and have a little chat, and then I'll let you know how it went afterwards. So let's pop into Tesco's.
It's Tesco's through a very dirty window.
I want all weapons to fire on that man. Oh, this is pretty good. This is pretty neat. Wow, they've got all out here. What have we got down here? We've got all the we've got the DVD, standard DVD, plus the beautiful Disney red slip, which is really nice. And also we've got the two different versions. So we've got the first order. I don't know if they got the other one. They've got Force Awakens there as well. So we've got the 4K, plus also the Force Awakens. Yeah, so that's pretty neat. That was a freaking awesome display. Hopefully the one over at Tesco's Westwood Cross is going to be huge. Probably the whole Battle of Crate or something. So anyway, let's go down here and have a look, see what we've got. Oh, I see some big sleeves. So it looks like they've put everything out already. There we go. Wow, £29. Big sleeve. Oh, damn it, you've put those stupid hubs on it again. They look really nice. I'm going to pick up a couple of these down Westwood Cross, but I'll pick up ones without the hubs on, because I don't like those stupid hubs. And here's the main section then. So yeah, we've got the two versions. We've got the first order Blu-ray, plus also the Resistance cover as well. And as I say, that's a really nice Disney red slip with the 3D logo, and you can actually see the 3D down the side there. So I think it's going to have some nice gloss on that one. Plus also the 4K as well, which I've got the steelbook, the Best Buy steelbook, so I don't need to buy that. I think that's probably the biggest release today. I don't think there's anything else. I'm just over here on the special deals section, and I noticed a lot of these Justice League figures they're trying to get rid of, and they've been reduced dramatically. They've already been reduced once, and now they're down to £2.44 a figure. And these are the ones that used to be like 15 quid. They've got quite a few. So they've got the Flash there, plus Batman, and also Superman. But the only thing is, I'm not sure on these moulds, because they're not that detailed. That's probably why they're not big sellers, plus also Aquaman. So if you want to get the figures, then you, by all means, pick them up for that cheap. And this big old pack down here of three figures, so you got all those three there, and they've actually reduced that to 30 quid. You can pick them up for £2.44 each over the other side there. So pretty good display so far. We're going to head off down to Westwood Cross now and see what they've got down there. I couldn't believe the price of those Justice League figures either. If the moulds had been a bit better on the faces, I probably would have picked them up, because I could have got like the whole, more or less nearly the whole set for about 10 quid. So anyway, let's head off down to Westwood Cross now. Okay guys, the next stop is Sainsbury's. So let's pop in there and have a look, see what they've got. Okay, so what display are we going to have here at the top of the escalator? Let's have a look. Oh yes. Oh yes. So we've got a very nice display here, with all the different titles in. So DVD £10, Blu-ray £15. Got all the mixed ones, the DVDs, the different covers, First Order, plus the Resistance covers, plus also you get a free book as well. It looks like a junior novel free book when you buy any of those. Plus also you got, it's a little BB-8 here, and a nice giant stand up of Chewie. Oh my god, look. Oh, lovely. Want to take that home. Okay, so we're at the Blu-ray section in Sainsbury's now. As you saw at the front there, you get a free book when you pick up the Last Jedi. There's the book. So if you buy it on DVD, Blu-ray 3D or 4K, it's just a junior novel, but that's pretty good. They're actually giving something away. Also out today is the Disaster Artist. I've heard a bit about this. I'm not really that familiar with it, but apparently it's the sequel to a film called The Room or something. So I'm not sure about that one. And also Unchained as well, with Adrian Brody and Antonio Banderas and John Malkovich. So from the producers of The Expendables. Yeah, so that looks pretty good. So that might be a bit of a good old action adventurer. And of course, they've got some other Star Wars bits and pieces here. So we've got the Force Awakens, plus we've got a couple of the 3D Force Awakens, which I would have thought these would have sold out ages ago. It's got a nice lenticular effect on there with the lightsaber. And also they've got Rogue One as well, but they haven't got any slips with them. Plus up here as well, we've got the complete saga as well, on Blu-ray for £50 with a nice embossed, look at that nice embossed Vader costume. That's really nice. And over here on the DVD section, we've got just the regular Last Jedi DVD. We'll see if we've got any other DVD releases today. So I think these are all from last week. We've got the Disaster Artist. I can't say that, Disaster Artist. Plus also Stronger as well with Jake Gyllenhaal and Tatiana Maslany. So that looks pretty good. And also Unchained there. And most of these are from the last couple of weeks, so there's not really anything new. And on the TV section here, I don't know why they've got The Crown here, because that's not new, that's been out for quite a while. But they've put all the other Star Wars animated ones up here, so we've got complete series 1 of Rebels, and series 2, and series 3, £7 to £10 each there. Here on the Great Value DVDs, they've got some very unusual covers for some like re-releases, which is exclusive to Sainsbury's. So we've got Sweet Charity. I take it these are all old films from maybe the 50s and 60s. Some of these I've not heard of. Charade, which has got Cary Grant in it. The Black Windmill. To Kill a Mockingbird. So they're very unusual covers. This Gun for Hire, starring Alan Ladd. I've not heard that one. So yeah, these are a lot of old classics and a touch of evil. They're quite good though, actually, when you look at all these covers together. So they might make a nice little collection. Okay, so I didn't pick anything up here at Sainsbury's, even though they had the Red Sleeve Disney. I'm hoping to pick that up maybe down at Tesco's, plus also some big sleeves as well. Because if I get them at Tesco's, I can get the Tesco's added points. So in a couple of months, I'll have enough points that I can probably pick up a free Blu-ray, which is always handy. So anyway, so let's head off down to Tesco. And I'll see you down there in one shake of a lightsaber. Okay, we're over at the local Tesco's now. So let's pop in there and have a look, see what they've got display-wise. And also have a look at the big sleeves and hopefully pick some up. Got to pick some up for a couple of group buy members, so let's stop waffling and get in there. We've got a nice big display here with all the different versions available, plus also the big sleeve in the middle. Now this should be right down the front of the store, so I don't know why they've got it at the back here, but that's probably the biggest display we've seen so far. We're here at HMV now. There's a lovely poster of Kylo Ren there. Some nice Star Wars stuff in the window. And a really nice one of Rey as well. So I suppose this has been sent out to all the stores to display. Plus lots of little trinkets and bits and pieces. And a little advert showing some pops as well. So let's pop in and have a look, see what is in HMV today. Thank you. Jurassic World is on its way. Okay, next stop of the day is Poundland. So let's go in and have a look, see if they've got any new Blu-rays today. Okay, looks like there's an extra couple of titles here in Poundland. So we've got Last Stand, the R&E film, which was a really good film. I enjoyed that film. Still got Man Down there. True Grit. Stakeland. They've got some older ones from the last couple of weeks mixed in as well. Death Riders, yet. Eddie Izzard. And Paranormal Activity. The Lost Boys. That's not the original, is it? The Thirst. It's one of the sequels. Plus also Che Part 1, which I've got both of those. So a few extra little ones, but nothing major. Stop of the day is the local Smith's Toys. So we'll go and have a look in there, see if they've got any Infinity War stuff or some maybe some Solo toys. Okay, they got some figures in here for the new Rampage movie with The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. Plus they got the giant Kong Skull Island again, and also the big new figure there from the Rampage. Plus lots of Infinity War stuff here, or lots of figures. £23. And he's got a bit of a... What are they doing with his hair on that? Looks like he's got some Brill cream on it or something. And the regular figures there as well, £10.99. Now this is those figures that was in Tesco's in Dover, and these are £12.99 in here, and they were £2.44 in Tesco's. Wow, that is a difference. With the Pops, I can't see anything Rogue One related. Well, Dr. Alan Grant, 25th anniversary Jurassic Park. That's a pretty good one. But yeah, I can't really see anything reduced for Rogue One. They've got the Iron Spider suit there for $9.99, and Wonder Woman. I was hoping there was going to be some Solo stuff in here. There's not a lot of Star Wars stuff at all. It looks like this is about it. So it's just the leftovers from The Last Jedi, with some Force Awakens stuff thrown in as well, with those reduced figures. So no delivery of any Solo stuff yet, so hopefully that will be happening in the next couple of weeks. Okay, so what I picked up in Tesco's was a load of big sleeves, which thankfully didn't have those stupid annoying security hubs around them. So I picked up four copies here, which are for a load of group buy members. All comes with 4K. So they look very nice. And there's the back in. So I will be doing an unboxing on my copy, hopefully within a couple of days. There wasn't anything else new in Tesco's that we hadn't seen in Sainsbury's. So basically Star Wars was it today, and a few other little low budget ones. And before heading over to Tesco's, I met up with a subscriber, a very nice chap, and his daughter. We met in Costa, had a lovely coffee. I had my usual gingerbread cream latte. And the cream, because I've never had it in store before. I usually have it takeaway, so it's usually in one of these containers. Well, a bit bigger. But the one I had in store, the mug, you had to use two fingers to pick the mug up. And the cream was about that thick on top. I'm sorry, Lulu. But my God, yeah, that was a big cappuccino. But it was very tasty. Maybe a little bit too much cream on top. But that's my naughtiness of the day. Yes, so meeting up with one of my subscribers, because he lives down this area, was really good. We had a good old chat about movies and all that kind of shit, personal life, where we used to work, all that kind of stuff. His daughter is adorable. she's kind of like the young teenage version of me. Wackiness and likes movies and all that kind of stuff. So that was really good. Hopefully at one point we may all go Blu-ray hunting, because I think that would be really good. And I think because we would bounce off each other, because we've all got a similar type of sense of humour, and we all like swearing just as much as well. So hopefully we'll meet up again. Really nice to meet both of you. And as I say, we should meet up again. If it's not to go to a movie, then to do a bit of Blu-ray hunting. But he did put me on to a shop that's nearby. That's kind of like a B&M. And they might have some nice toys in there. So I'm going to go and find it now. Hopefully I won't get lost, because I kind of know the direction that we're pointing to. So I have no idea what kind of shop it is. But it's like B&M, so we'll go and have a look down there. So I shall see you down at this shop. I can't remember what he said it was called. But anyway, I'll see you down there in a minute.
Okay, we're down at that store that my subscriber was talking about. And it's Home Bargains, which I think there's one actually in Folkestone. So we're going to pop in there. I don't recall actually going into the Folkestone one that often. I think I might have been in there maybe once. But that was quite a long time ago. So we'll go in and have a look, see if there's any toys. And over here, if I turn the camera around. Yes, yeah, so over here is a big building, which is the Hornby building, where they make all the Hornby, you know, the trains, the little toy trains. And that's been there for as long as I can remember. So anyway, so let's pop into the Home Bargains and have a look. There is a B&Q as well, so I might pop in there and see if there's any canvas. You never know, I haven't been to this B&Q at all, so let's go and have a look. Okay, so we're at the toy section now.
Toys and games.
So there's a couple of good pieces in here. It's very similar to B&M. So we've got a couple of Finding Dory type things. Bailey, I don't know if they're things that you can just put in your bath and just let swim about. There's some like minifigures there. Plus also there's a couple of Wonder Woman figures here for £2.99. by a company called Schleich, whatever. Down the bottom here we've got a nice big figure pack for £17.99. A couple of individual figures as well from like Thunderbirds, some Marvel Infinite Series figures there. Plus also some Disney Infinity figures as well. That looks good, it's got a Death Star on that one. Some other figures down here from Avengers. It's got a couple of Rogue One figures here. And some Pirates of the Caribbean stuff. And we've got, what have we got down here? Some Star Wars stuff. Looks like there's a kind of like a plush BB-8. And some lightsabers. A Yondu figure there. We've got a wrestling figure here as well. Sting. That looks like that's £4.99. We do like knocking stuff down in the stores, don't we? And also there's a figure here from Heatwave, is it? Oh, right, yes, Heatwave from Flash. So that's pretty good. And also Cyborg as well. Bit of a crushed box there, and with a couple of extra Game of Thrones figures, a large one, a Robb Stark one, and some Finding Dory stuff there. So there's a fair bit in here, varied between toys, you know, Star Wars, and look, they've even got their own van as well, their own lorry. We've got some more Star Wars stuff down here, pinball game. A 12-inch super deformed plush. What the hell? She is a bit deformed, isn't she? Where the bloody hell's her legs? Plus also a nice Darth Vader figure there. And some other little figures here. Very nice. Some Finn figures there for £5.99. I should imagine you get quite a bit more during the Christmas period. So that's about it on the Tory series. So it's very much similar to B&M, but coming near Christmas should probably be a little bit more. Now, who's up for me riding that? There's actually another aisle of toys here. So it's all like board games and things like that. Some minion stuff, poker chips, lots of novelty stuff. With some little fluffies up the top there. So this is aimed at the smaller kiddie area. So I don't think I'm going to be buying any of this stuff. But yeah, it's quite a bit there. Quite reasonably priced as well. But there is something I've seen that Claire might like. Either a cycling Paddington or a dancing Paddington. What a lovely shirt. I need to start wearing shirts like that in the summer. Okay, so as I say, it's got quite a varied set of toys in there, but I think there'll be more toys come Christmas, or especially after some big event like after Infinity War or the Han Solo film. So we're going to pop over to B&Q here and have a look, just in case there's any like Rogue canvas. So I'll see you in there in a minute. So it looks like they just got the same ones that they had in the Dover one, that store, that time. So just a couple of scenery ones with the Spider-Man and the Batman one. The only other big one here is the Fantastic Beasts and where to find them. Both of them. Both of these ones were in the Dover quite a while ago. And they're reduced down to £7 now. I don't think there's anything else behind, so it just looks like it's trying to get rid of those. I'm trying to aim for something Star Wars, so although they look very nice, I think I'll pass on those for now.
Okay, so didn't find anything in Home Bargains or B&Q that I wanted to pick up. So hopefully we'll try that Home Bargains again a little bit closer to one of the big release dates for, say, like Infinity War, or maybe coming on the way up to Christmas, because they'll probably get shitloads of stuff in then. So we're going to pop off home now to Dover. Our last stop of the day is going to be B&M. Have a look, see what toys they got in there, if anything new, and then that will be about it, and I shall show you what I've got today. So I'll see you back in Dover in about 30 minutes.
They put the toys right at the back of the store, so you've got to walk all the way around the store, around the back, before you can actually get to the toys. Put them at the front. Okay, I think they've got a few more pops in, £4.99. So they've got Civil War 1 War Machine. I don't think they had that last time. They had Black Widow. But I don't think they had Agent 13. Not if I remember right. Oh yes, and they've still got those Star Wars ones here. For the Maz Kanata and the Princess Leia. So they're still here for £4.99. And there's a pop-up here for £4.99. Pop game called Widowmaker for Overwatch. Okay, I'm not familiar with that. Anything new on the DVDs? Don't think so. They've got Hotel Transylvania 1 and 2, both for £4.99. And they've got looks like the original Smurfs there for £2.99 as well, and Kung Fu Panda for £3.99. And Ice Age, so you've got the Continental Drift there for £2.99 as well, plus Collision Course as well. And they've got the Lord of the Rings ones here. I like these DVDs for £3.99. I like these ones with the gold outsides, you know, the gold cases. So we've got Battle of the Five Armies, the Desolation of Smaug, and they're actually really good covers. That's a really good cover. I don't think they've got the first one. No, they haven't got the first one, so that's a bit of a shame, because they actually look really nice together. Hey everyone, so back from the shops. I'm just going to show you what I've got today. I've got four pickups for my group buy members, plus a couple of gifts from my subscribers that I met down in Costa. So I shall show you what I've got. So this is the pickup for the day, which is the big sleeve edition of The Last Jedi. And as I say, I've got a load of these, four or five copies of these for my group buy members. I will be unboxing it within a couple of days or so when I've got around to doing all my other bits and pieces. So that's that. I didn't pick up the red Disney sleeve 3D. I was going to, but I'm waiting on my 3D steelbook from Zavi. And it's only just shipped today, this afternoon. It's only been charged and shipped this afternoon. So where's the policy of actually getting it on day of delivery? You gits. So anyway, I'm going to have to wait a couple of days for that. So a couple of lovely gifts that I got from my subscribers from Dan Costa. Why didn't you video the meeting, or at least tell us their names? I hear you say. Well, it was our first meeting and I thought we'd just keep it casual. So no names, no video, nice coffee, get to know each other, and we'll see how it goes from there. You know, if we go Blu-ray hunting or maybe go and see a film, maybe then we'll do a full video. It was very nice meeting both of them. His daughter is absolutely adorable. She's like a teenage girl version of Big Pauly. Kind of, not nuts. I can't say that, can I? But she's very quirky and she likes her films and she likes to tell you all about it, which is fantastic. So let's get on to the gifts, because these are absolutely beautiful gifts. So the first gift, first item, is a hardback book. So it's a very nice Star Wars Last Jedi visual dictionary. And you can see a nice gloss on there. All the pictures, so we'll have a look inside, see what it's like inside. Yes, look, absolutely fantastic inside. Lots of glossy photos. So I'm gonna spend an absolute, oh my God, I'm gonna spend an absolute ages looking at this and reading these. So that's the visual dictionary. And also another book, which is really nice. And it's quite a big one as well. It's Incredible Cross Sections for the Last Jedi. And that's got a nice glossy feel to it as well. So we've got lots of lovely ships, pictures and glossy photos. So yeah, look at that. Oh my God, I'm gonna be spending ages looking at these. So thank you very much, guys, for those. It's really appreciated. And also, I've got a nice t-shirt as well. It's a 2XL, so I'm not sure if it's gonna fit me. Hopefully it will. So let me just take it out of the bag. If not, it's a very nice item, kind of like a collectible. It does actually look quite big-ish. I don't know if you can see that. There. And Solo, A Star Wars Story. And as you can see, it says Action Vehicles. And this is like one of the, I believe this is like one of the crew t-shirts for working on the actual models of the Solo movie. So I don't know how they came about that, but it's a very nice t-shirt. It's a very nice collectible t-shirt. The door's just been pushed open because Bobby's just wandered in. Hello, Bobby, if you miss me. So that's a beautiful t-shirt there. So I'm going to try and squeeze in it. Don't push the tripod, Bobby. That's a good girl. So yeah, so that's my little gifts from the guys. As I say, great meeting it was. Hopefully we'll do it again soon. That's about it for today, but stay tuned in a couple of seconds because I've got a little video that I recorded earlier this morning when the new Solo Star Wars Story trailer actually broke. So this was very early this morning. I was barely up and I got my reaction to it. So I was really looking forward to it. So stay tuned to that in a couple of minutes. But as for Blu-ray Monday, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Give the video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Stick down in the comments what your favourite part of The Last Jedi was, if you had a specific scene or part of the story that you really thought was really good, or any of the other Star Wars films as well. What's your favourite parts of any of the Star Wars films? So as I say, guys, stay tuned for the Solo trailer reaction, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye, and may the Force be with you. Okay, guys, it's really early on Monday morning, and the trailer for the new Han Solo movie has dropped. So we're going to stick it on for the first time and see what this is going to be like. I'm excited. Hopefully there's going to be a lot more unveiled from the previous trailer, because that still left me kind of a bit... So here we go, and hit it! Oh, TIE fighter in the background.
You're after something.
Is it very Western feeling? Expecting Clint Eastwood in the background or something.
Money.
He does look really good there.
Is it something else? You look good. A little rough around the edges.
He does, actually.
Heard about a job. Big shot gangster putting together crew.
I'm a driver. And I'm a flyer.
Oh, it's going to have some great action pieces.
For a shot like this.
What do you think? Well, what do you know?
I think there's going to be a lot of good humor in this film.
He's the best smuggler around.
I heard a story about you. I was wondering if it's true.
Everything you've heard about me is true.
Oh, yes. Give us some more Lando.
Let's go with a mean man's face.
Who are these guys?
I love that we're getting another droid.
You're in this life for good.
You might want to.
Oh, wow.
Up, baby.
Oh, yes. Oh, the Convey-X.
Let me give you some.
That's going to be so iconic.
I assume everyone will betray you, and you will never be disappointed.
Wow. Chewie's mum or his wife? Hope it's not the holiday special all over again.
You look great.
He does, actually. Oh, what? Oh, that's painful. That robot sounded a bit like Captain Phasma. Fantastic. That is so much better than the first trailer. That gave us a lot more detail. As I said, it's kind of like, it's more of a Western feel. It's going to be kind of like along the lines of Rogue One, I think. Very dark, a very dark Star Wars film. But yeah, I wish there had been a little bit more Lando, although that's enough to keep us going, because we've only got, a couple of weeks to... Yeah, we've only got a couple of weeks to wait, haven't we? Only about a month and a bit. So, like I said, I'm so happy that there's another droid that's going to be the focus of it, you know, because K2SO was really, really good, really funny in Rogue One, and kind of iconic, you know, with R2 and C-3PO and all the other androids. So I'm glad we've got another robot. That's what I meant, robot, not android.
I'll be back.
But anyway, yeah, I'm really impressed with that trailer. I don't think we need another one. So we can just go into the film now and be pleasantly surprised. Hopefully there's going to be lots of surprises in the film. I know there was a hint that maybe Boba Fett might be in the film. Because when Ron Howard posted a picture, kind of in the background was like a silhouette of like Boba Fett's head. So I don't know. So we'll see if there's any surprises in the film. I'm sure it's going to tie in a bit with the main movies. So anyway... Looking forward to it. So thanks for watching my little trailer reaction. I think I might watch it a couple more times now, because I'm sure I missed a load. So till next time, bye.